Manchester United is going to lose points to Leicester either 2 or all 3, because none of its top players will be in the match tomorrow. Wan-Bissaka is a doubt. He's Manchester United's star player, alongside with Anthony Martial, who's injured. They're not going to be there, so you're going to miss them. Paul Pogba is not going to be there as well. And as I have mentioned in earlier episodes, Manchester United only have one route to go, which is through the middle. And if you notice, most of that action, it is coming from Paul Pogba, either with the long balls ahead to Rashford or the through passes. No one else in Manchester United can do that. And if nobody else steps up, it means Manchester United will not have an outlet for attack. So it's probably going to lose points there. And like now with Leicester, Leicester has the players that are performing are on the pitch. The players that have been informed are on the pitch. You're looking at Pereira, you're looking at Ndidi. And Ndidi is going to be very important, because to further compound the problem Manchester United has of not having Pogba to thread the passes through the middle, Ndidi is actually doing very well in intercepting movement of the ball in the center. So he'll be there to block whoever is there to replace Paul Pogba as Manchester United try to create chances through the middle. So summary of that first point is Manchester United will be choked. It will not have a way to attack, which will only leave Leicester with the opportunity to attack it. And we know that it's very good at doing that, considering that Maddison is going to be attacking Victor Lindelof, who has been prone to mistakes and has already cost Manchester United 5 points because of his mistakes this season. Brendan Rodgers is a better coach than Ole Gunnar Solskjaer, so expect him to outwit Ole Gunnar Solskjaer tactically in terms of influencing the match from the bench. Ole Gunnar Solskjaer usually sticks to one formation, the 4-2-3-1, which is shown to be ineffective. And the way he set up the team, like I already said, has led to Manchester United having one route to go. Brendan Rodgers, on the other hand, is not afraid to tinker with his formations and with his substitutions. And in the last three games, when Brendan Rodgers has made a change, a goal has resulted for Leicester, only once for the opposition, of which Leicester came back. So if Brendan Rodgers can actually affect the game from the bench, Ole Gunnar Solskjaer has not. And I've been complaining about this since the tail end of last season. So what happens is, when Brendan Rodgers changes his formation and makes his substitutions, Manchester United is going to be found wanting. But if you notice, in addition to only having one route to go, Manchester United cannot adjust in many ways. It's probably a one-track team, and Rodgers will know this and will manipulate this to the highest level. Also, Leicester have got a thing for forcing errors from opposition teams. In the last four games, they've forced errors in three games in a row from the opposition to score a goal. And you know already, like I mentioned, Victor Lindelof has made mistakes that have led to Manchester United losing 5 points. So with that combination, expect Leicester to force Lindelof or somebody else into a mistake, which further gives Leicester the advantage in this match. A key battle Manchester United is going to lose is in the middle. You cannot compare McTominay and whoever is going to be with him, probably Matic, to the force that is Maddison, Tielemans and Ndidi sitting as a defensive midfielder. So you know, creativity wise, Manchester United is going to be beat by Tielemans and Maddison, especially considering that Ndidi and Tielemans are also good defensive wise. Matic and McTominay have shown in the first four games that they're not very good defensive wise. That's an area Manchester United is going to lose the ball. And since they also don't have their own answer attack wise, it means route one for Leicester is through the middle, and it's going to be attack after attack. I see actually Leicester dominating this game, even position wise, unless Brendan Rodgers comes in with a lot of respect for Manchester United. Another area in which Manchester United is going to lose the match is at the wing backs, the battle of the wing backs, especially at the side of Pereira. From last season, Pereira has continued to shine, and he will storm down that right flank for Leicester, attacking Ashley Young, who we know right now is out of sorts. He's leaking. Yes, Ashley Young is doing better than Luke Shaw and most Manchester United by creating a lot of chances up front, but going back, he's not really doing much. And this will actually create a problem, because this will leave Maguire in the middle of Ashley Young and Lindelof. As you already know, Lindelof is prone to mistakes and has cost Manchester United points, and Ashley Young will be leaking. So while Maguire will be looking to help Ashley Young deal with Pereira and his attempts to assist or to score, he'll else be left with Lindelof and nobody to watch him, and a mistake can be made from that side, because Lindelof will also be attacked by Madison. So that action from all angles is going to be overwhelming for a young Maguire, who, even though Ole Gunnar Solskjaer for some absurd reason wants to call him a future leader, has shown that he cannot shepherd that back yet. He cannot captain that back yet. He's not able to actually deal with the issues Lindelof is facing, and is actually not able to keep a clean sheet for Manchester United. So those key battles Manchester United are going to lose, and they're going to be key in actually deciding how this match goes. Leicester, I expect Leicester to actually control possession against Manchester United, because the only person who can actually control possession in Manchester United, as I have mentioned in earlier episodes, is Paul Pogba, and Paul Pogba is not in the match. So when there's no one like Paul Pogba to hold the ball and to dictate play, you shall see Manchester United losing a lot of the possession, as they'll just be moving the ball around. None of the players can actually command control of the ball in one area like Paul Pogba does. Leicester has got somebody who can do that in Pereira, and the other right back, sorry, the other center back at the left, I think his name is Sonku, something like that. These people can actually control possession, even though Pereira is the one who's going to be doing it the most. So while Leicester has a possession general, Manchester United will not. And as I've already alluded to in last week's episode, the forwards also at Manchester United cannot hold possession, so they'll just be moving it around, looking to attack the goal and being dispossessed, with the possession being turned over against Manchester United. So that's another key area. Leicester has actually got someone to control possession with. Manchester United does not. So expect Leicester to actually control possession and dictate the play. As far as creativity is concerned, Leicester has got two midfield generals who are going to be creating chances for them in the form of Tielemans and Maddison. And you know that I know that you know that Victor Lindelof will not be able to do anything about Maddison. I propose that Ole Gunnar Solskjaer make a gamble and substitute Lindelof, maybe with somebody like Royal. Maybe they might actually get some bit of luck, because Maddison is going to be forcing mistakes out of Lindelof. Now, Manchester United only has one creative force, who is Paul Pogba, and Paul Pogba is not in the match. So probably expect Mata to start, but he'll be starting from up top. And Mata as well, even though he's quite good at holding possession, is not strong enough to do it for a long period of time, and he doesn't have players up front who can assist him. If he can offload the ball to a player and get it back, and offload and get it back, since he cannot hold it himself, there's no player he can actually do that with. So he will not assist that much in the situation, and there'll be nobody feeding Mata from the midfield so that he can actually create something for United. So Leicester has got two people are going to be creating the chances, creating the spaces, and helping the movement, controlling the game from the middle. Manchester United has nobody. And since Leicester already has somebody controlling the possession, in addition to that, and Manchester United does not have, I do not see how Manchester United will get away with this straight up. I think they probably will play on the counter and hope that Rashford can make something. Now, the problem is Soinkyu, I hope I get that name well, is very good at intercepting balls from the defense. So anybody who tries to get the ball to Rashford will have that to deal with. And there's also Johnny Evans, who's quite quick, will be playing the anchor, with Soinkyu playing the sweeper. So it's looking very bleak for United. Something that Leicester City can do that other teams, including Manchester United, cannot do is to attack from many different points. Leicester will mostly attack United through their right flank, with Perez combining with Pereira. These players have got a very great ability in terms of penetrating defenses, and they'll dribble past James and Ashley Young, who's already leaking before this match, very easily. So a lot of chances for Leicester will come through that side. And to compound the problem for Ashley Young and Maguire is the fact that on that side of the pitch, there's also Yuri Tielemans, who's also very good at penetrating. So they'll have people attacking them from many different points, moving fast, combining in 1-2-1-2 formations, creating triangles and the sorts. Now, this will also have the impact of taking Harry Maguire's eye off Lindelof. Yes, he's already not been doing a good job of shepherding or captaining the back line, but this situation will make it worse, because Lindelof will also have his hands full with Maddison, who is also very good at penetrating. Okay, so basically across the pitch, right up to Maddison, from Perez down to Pereira, it's going to be attack after attack after attack, and combinations. Manchester United will not only have to worry about the defensive issues, but the fact that the Pereira and Perez will push back Daniel James, who's had quite a good start, but he's a kid who just needs space to actually create something. If he's up against it, I don't see him producing anything. So not only will that combination down the right of Leicester's squad cause problems defensively for United, it will also stifle Manchester United's attack from that side. Also consider the fact that behind Tielemans and Madison, there is Ndidi, who's also very good at penetrating. So that middle, like I already said, Leicester is going to run it, and it's basically going to run the match from the right of the pitch. A painful fact for Manchester United fans is this is a game that Paul Pogba would really have taken off. Yes, he's got the stats that are decent right now for his position, but like I mentioned, he's only managing to perform when the opposition makes a mistake, either tactically or otherwise. So Paul Pogba is not really running at full throttle, but with the way Leicester plays, this could have been a game that Paul Pogba would have shown. Why am I saying that? If you look at Madison, Tielemans, Ndidi, Pereira, as good as they are attack-wise, they're just as poor defensively. Paul Pogba would have been able to fashion chances across them all day, every day. And in the end, who knows, he might have been able to do more than the damage that Leicester could actually do to Manchester United. So this is an opportunity missed for the great talisman Paul Pogba to actually make an impact and get his season starting off. What I mean here is him actually forcing matters and dictating play and forcing teams backward and actually creating those chances when in fact the other team has not made a mistake, unlike has been the case right now. So in a situation where Paul Pogba is sulking about the Real Madrid move, this is a missed opportunity for Ole Gunnar Solskjaer to actually get a happier Paul Pogba for Manchester United. Leicester has got more options of attacking than Manchester United. I'm sure at this point it's already clear they can come through the fullbacks with Chilwell and Pereira, who are better than Manchester United's combination. They can come through the middle with Madison and Tielemans. I've already mentioned that their wingers, yeah, they're good at combination plays, but we'll not talk much about that. So that's two ways that they can attack. The third one is actually one of the strongest that they have, because it's also one of Manchester United's weakest points. I've been mentioning this throughout the season, from the start of this season going on to the tail end of last season. Manchester United is poor in the air, but Leicester is a beast in the air, kind of like reminds me of Burnley. So how can they attack from the air? They've got Jamie Vardy, who can be used to actually attack Lindelof. Yuri Tielemans is also very good in the air. Johnny Evans is very good in the air. So Junku is actually also very good in the air. I've also probably missed one or two. Manchester United only has one person who's good in the air right now, who is Maguire. So attack wise in open play, we've got nobody doing it in the air for us, but Leicester City has got probably three or four players who can do it for them. And then from set pieces, Manchester United again only has Maguire, because the other person who's quite okay in the air, even though he has not scored from the air in a long time, was Paul Pogba, is out injured. From set pieces, Leicester will actually have five people who are good in the air. So if they decide to take the game to the air, that's Manchester United beaten, or probably a draw if Manchester United get lucky. So Leicester have got three ways in which they can attack Manchester United. Manchester United only has, actually, it's got zero. Like I said, going through the middle is now not an option because Paul Pogba is injured. So it's just going to be scrambling. Leicester, three ways to attack. Manchester United, zero. Only talked about the air going forward. Also defensively, Leicester has got players who actually pitch in defensively in the air, so this will make them more solid than Manchester United defensively in that aspect. They only don't have Soyuncu and Evans doing it for them. Vardy actually puts a lot of defensive work in the air. You also find Tielemans, Choudhury, also Ayoze Perez playing a part in the air, though only the likes of Madison probably will not actually help in that respect. Manchester United, in the same respect, only has Harry Maguire, who is an expert in the air. Lindelof, as you've already noticed, has been attacked in the air by Schlupp against Crystal Palace and by Vestergaard against Southampton, and has lost both those battles to the detriment of Manchester United. So expect Leicester to also be solid more solid than United in the air at the back. I already mentioned that Leicester is going to be controlling the match and position, and another reason why is because Manchester United is not as good as Leicester in terms of actually stopping the opposition from playing. If you look at Leicester, it's got people high up the pitch like Maddison, Shaduri, Perez, Ndidi and Telemans who can actually attack someone coming from the opposition and dispossess them off the ball. So what this does now is if you're being dispossessed off the ball high up the pitch, the turnover of position is going to be coming from closer to goal. This means that defenders will have less time to rest in between attacking waves, and this is what usually leads the opposition to make mistakes. Like I said, Lindelof is somebody you want to consider in terms of making mistakes. There's a chance that he's going to make another mistake tomorrow. This is probably the reason why Leicester, like I mentioned earlier, has already managed to force errors that have led to goals in the last three straight matches. I would not be surprised if Manchester United is the fourth victim in a row because of the fact. Now, if you look at Manchester United, can it do the same? Can it actually stop Leicester from completing its plays from high up the pitch? No, it can't, because the only person who can actually attack a defender and dispossess them of the ball is actually Aaron Wan-Bissaka, who is deep in the Manchester United lineup at the back. I already said the people who actually can do some interceptions for Leicester are up the pitch, meaning they'll be able to stop Manchester United in its tracks earlier than Manchester United can stop Leicester in its tracks. Tillemans and Maddison and the likes, like I mentioned, are not even the best people at stopping plays, obviously the defenders, but this is the advantage Leicester has. Also, considering that Wan-Bissaka is most likely not starting, it means Manchester United does not have anybody who can interrupt Leicester City's fast-paced passing play, and this is going to lead to disaster. I already mentioned that Brendan Rodgers is better tactically than Ole Gunnar Solskjaer and has the ability to affect the match more from the bench. To aid him in this, he's actually got a stronger bench than Ole Gunnar Solskjaer's bench. If you look at Manchester United's bench, it's got the likes at times of Twanzebe, Chong, maybe Juan Mata, Marcos Rojo, Sergio Romero and the likes, who can't really be brought in to make an impact. I mean, let me know in the comments below which Manchester United substitutes do you think can actually come in and change the match, maybe outside Mata. I know the fans are crying out for Greenwood to give him a start, but he's just an inverted winger like everybody else on that pitch for Manchester United, so not really much of a difference coming from him. But if you look at Leicester City, on the wings, it's got actually a lot of choice there. It changes sometimes. Maddison, Shaduri, also Brighton, Perez. You see other people coming in like Damari, Gray, create a very good rotation around that midfield. Also looking at the defense, Fuchs is a very good replacement for Chilwell, and vice versa. So you're messing with the team with a better coach and a better Arsenal on his bench, meaning that going into the match, if Manchester United are not in control around the 60th minute, expect Brendan Rodgers to take over and actually control the rest of the game. It is what it is. Leicester have got more depth on the bench. The fact that Leicester attacks relentlessly and quickly is going to create problems for Manchester United, as this will lead to a lot of corners being conceded by Manchester United. Now, this is a problem because Leicester City is far more superior than Manchester United in this respect. As you know, I've been talking about Manchester United being poor from corners. The last time they actually converted a corner kick was way back last season, probably towards the start. That's the last I can remember, when Kachunga actually deflected the ball onto Matic, who actually then scored from the corner kick. Now, Leicester is a whole different proposition on this issue. You've got James Maddison, who actually is very good and very accurate with his corners. Sometimes getting to accuracy levels of 100% means 100% of the time he actually manages to find his man in the box. Now, when he finds his man in the box, he's got the option ranging from Vardy to Ndidi, who are very good players in the air who can actually thunderbolt the ball into the back of the net. So as much as United will be getting attacked, let's hope you do not be actually letting corners in, because that's another aspect Leicester has an advantage of that it can actually take advantage of. So this is it, guys. Manchester United is in trouble. Leicester City seems to have advantages all over the pitch, and advantages in all respects. I can actually not think of a situation in which Manchester United actually has an advantage. I know it might seem to you Manchester United fans like I've got a thing against the club, but the club is doing poor for a reason. And if you look at this analysis, it's actually shocking to see why the bookies have got Leicester City to win at 4, a draw at about 3.75 odds, and Manchester United to win at about 1.95. Maybe they're considering home advantage, but I think the bookies are doing one over here. I'd expect a very sharp punter to probably go for at least a double chance on Leicester, or if you're feeling bullish, to go for the odds of 4.0 for Leicester to win. If you put in $100, you get $400 back, which is $300 profit. I think it's actually a good investment that you can make. But just to be safe, play a double chance. It will probably come in at odds of around 1.95, which is a 95% return on your money. If you put 10,000, you get 9,500 back. If you put $100, you get $95 back, which is good money. But I would not expect anybody worth their salts in the betting arena to actually bet for Manchester United to win even a double chance. I think it's a long shot. Looking at what I'm seeing here, Manchester United is in trouble. Its talisman, its best players, Martial, Pogba, Juan Bissaka, are out for Leicester. All their best players are in, both on the pitch and on the bench. Players that they don't have playing like Amati are not really important players. So this is my take. Let me know in the comment section below what you think about my analysis. Do you think I'm going to get it right, or do you think I'm going to get it wrong, and why? Just like the channel, click on the notification bell, because I'm going to keep those videos coming to support the channel and help it grow, so that I can keep providing those insights that will give you the fan or the watcher an edge over other fans, because the knowledge that I just dish out is pretty awesome. Thanks.